Welcome to Yosemite in under 5 minutes. I'm Steve from rippletraining.com. No doubt you've already downloaded or you're about to download Apple's latest operating system, OS 10.10, aka Yosemite. In the next several minutes, I'm going to give you the express tour of the most important changes to your Mac desktop. Let's begin with markup. Markup allows you to draw and add text to screenshots or images to any message you're composing inside Mail or within the Preview app. You can also create custom signatures via the camera or using a wireless trackpad. To make sure it's enabled, go to System Preferences, Extensions, Actions, and make sure this checkbox is checked. Now, in any PDF, screenshot, image, or preview window, you can start marking up your photo or document to get across whatever point you need to make. Tab view in Safari is the perfect solution for those like me who have more browser tabs open than they can count or even identify. By clicking the Stack Paper button in the upper right of the window, your tabs are presented in a nice grid layout. Simply click the square for the web page you want to bring forward, then keep adding tabs to your heart's content. The Notification Center has been completely remodeled and flattened to look like its iOS 8 counterpart. It's very similar to the iOS 8 Notification Center in almost every way. The Today tab holds all your widgets, like your calendar or today's summary, allowing you to easily and clearly see what's on your plate today. It's also a fast way to post to LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, or start an iMess conversation. The Notifications tab gives you an easy way to track all of your social media platforms without ever having to open a web browser or an actual application. You can click the menu icon in the top right of the OS X interface to reveal the Notification Center, or if you have a trackpad, you can swipe to the right with two fingers. Spotlight has a completely new look and some added functionality. You can search Spotlight for files on your Mac as always, but now you can search the web for answers too. For example, if I type in Steve Jobs, it comes up with a Wikipedia article, books on Steve Jobs and iBooks, audiobooks in my iTunes library, Steve Jobs movies in iTunes, and the definition of Steve Jobs in the dictionary. Handoff is one of the big new features that was added into Yosemite. Handoff allows you to browse the web, begin a draft of an email on your iPad or iPhone, then open them up right from where you left off on your Mac, or vice versa. To enable Handoff, go to System Preferences, and choose iCloud and sign in with the same Apple ID that is used on your mobile device. Now on your mobile device, go to Settings, General, Handoff, and Suggested Apps and make sure Handoff is enabled. Being able to answer a call on your Mac desktop that's coming in from your iPhone will save you from ever having to say your phone was on silent. Or perhaps you left your phone in your car or in your bedroom charging, or in your pants from the night before. To set up calling on your Mac, make sure your iPhone, Mac, or iPad are on the same Wi-Fi network. Then launch FaceTime on your Mac and log into FaceTime using the same Apple ID that was used to register your iPhone. You're now ready to receive FaceTime calls or just straight up audio calls on your Mac or iPad. Of course, you must have iOS 8 and Yosemite to do this. You may have noticed my menu bar and dock are darker than normal. This is achieved using a new feature called Dark Mode. Apple created and specifically designed this for when you're using applications like Final Cut Pro 10 and iMovie, allowing you to not be distracted by the OS X interface. To enable Dark Mode, go to System Preferences, General, and check the box for Dark Mode. Welcome to the dark side.